If you are happy with your work or you get a kick out of your work, you know, it's a great part of life. If you don't, you can't expect anybody else to enjoy it either. I'm an author and illustrator of four series of children's books, and they would include biographies of great artists, composers, US presidents, and inventors and scientists. And I got interested in this a number of years ago when my kids were younger. They didn't have an art teacher at their school, their grade school. And I thought, well, maybe there's a better way to do this, to get kids interested in artists and in art. And at one point I thought, well, you know, there's no books out for children between the ages of 7 and 10 about great artists. So maybe I could do one. And when I saw the first two books, Picasso and Rembrandt, all bound together and, you know, color, you know, covers and stuff. And I thought, wow, this is great. Maybe someday I could have 6 books. Well, the first two started selling really well. So they asked me, well, can you do 2 more? Then they asked, can you do 3 more? And all of a sudden, I had something like 47 artist books. And I thought, well, why can't we do books on great composers? Because I also love music. So I write my books as though I were my 9-year-old self and try to answer the questions I would have had. Sometimes twist things, and that might even make a better point, you know, because it's like how I would have thought of something. It's like, wait a minute, what does that mean? I might draw the wait a minute, what does that mean? And then answer the question. I love people who have inspired me over the years, like Gary Larson, who did the, you know, the Far Side. Probably my greatest inspiration is, okay, this, Mad Magazine. And Mad Magazine, I remember when I was 10 years old in 5th grade, some kid brought a Mad Magazine to school. And when I saw that cover, the front and back cover, and I thought, wow, how can anybody do this? This opened up a whole new world, a way to look at things that was outrageous and funny. And I would like kids to get a feeling that, you know, they could do the same kind of thing. They could use their creativity. You know, when I'm working on some of these people, some of these great inventors and scientists, each and every one of them was creative. Art is, to me, extremely important. And, you know, hopefully people will realize that creativity and art and dance and music are as important as math and science. Because if you're going to be a math person, you can be better if you're creative. If you're going to be a scientist, you can be better if you're creative.